When you give others a project for them to do the work for you, then you say, 수고 좀 해주세요. This means, please put in an effort for this work. And then, when you leave them because you want them to go back to work, then you say, 수고하세요. So in this case, 수고하세요 can be goodbye for now. And when you come back and see them and see that they did your work well, you say, 수고하셨습니다. Or you put in much effort in this. Or you can say, 고생하셨어요. 고생하셨어요 means, oh, you took trouble in this matter. Oh, you put yourself into trouble for this matter. 수고하셨어요 can be said in another way, like 수고하셨습니다. And 고생하셨어요 can be said in another way, like 고생하셨습니다. 수고하셨습니다, 고생하셨습니다 are both compliments for them because they did the work very well. And then you can say 감사합니다. 감사합니다 is official thank you. 고맙습니다 is thank you conversational style. When other person say 감사합니다 and 고맙습니다 to you, you can answer that 고맙습니다, 감사합니다 like 천만의 말씀입니다. 천만의 말씀입니다 can be not at all in English. 별 말씀입니다 can be don't mention it in English. But the person who took your project and couldn't complete it yet, and the person could say, 죄송합니다. 아직 못 끝냈습니다. I am sorry. Finish it yet. Then you say, 괜찮습니다. Oh, it's okay. When you want to accept other person's apology, you say, 괜찮습니다. 걱정하지 마세요. Don't worry about it. 그럼 계속 수고 좀 해주세요. Please continue. Put in an effort for this. Today we learned how to ask others to do something for you and how to compliment their work and how to accept their apology. Thank you very much.